Let's take a look at the eMo IEM, which is an add-on for the LV1 mixing console. So it's a part of the console, but you need a license in order to actually be able to use it. So with this add-on, you will be able to mix in-ear monitors in a more immersive way, either using the LV1 console or using the iPad app. So you can, of course, mix things left to right and all the way around to have the sound coming from behind, even though it doesn't really sound like it's coming from behind. But we will take a listen and see how it actually sounds. But the basic thing is that this add-on unlocks the immersive mixing environment. So let's take a look. So with Waves LV1 version 15, the eMo IEM system is already included in the software, but you need a license in order to be able to use it. So in the description, you will find a link to Waves homepage where you can buy the license. Then just activate it on Wave Central and restart the old system and you're good to go. So with the license activated, you can go to the AUXes, and here you will find that on the channel config you have mono, stereo and now IEM. This is one way of turning it on. Another way would be to, let's get rid of this one, is to go up here on modes on the eMo IEM and just turn it on over here. And with this turned on, you will see that, let's go back to the channels. If we go to the stereo aux, you can see that the pans look as they always do. If we go to an aux with the new eMo IEM, these pan settings will turn to, yeah, it's a head, and you can then drag things all the way around. So left, right, and all the way to behind your head. And it's kind of hard to take a look at this and not compare it to the Klang system. And the Klang system is absolutely more advanced. You can do a whole lot more stuff. With Klang, you need hardware, you need a whole lot of stuff, and it's kind of expensive as well. This is, in comparison to Klang, very, very inexpensive. But with Klang, you have, of course, the surround, same as with Waves, but then you have the distance and also the height. With eMo IEM, with Waves, you only have panning, so you can only just pan things around your head. But it's really not just panning, and we will get into that later on, and I will show you kind of under the hood stuff. So compared to Klang, this is absolutely a lot more basic, but that can be a good thing as well, because Klang is very, very advanced. So it's really a lot easier to get started with Waves. So let's get started. So in order to understand what this is all about, we obviously need to have a listen. I would suggest you hit pause and get your in-ears. If you don't have in-ears, headphones will work as well, even though you get more of the experience with the in-ears. So let's start with the regular stereo mix, and let's not really pay attention to the mix per se, but let's have a listen to the difference between the stereo and the more immersive way. Let's go. I don't wanna go, but baby, we both know this is not our time. It's time to say goodbye until we meet again, 'cause this is not the end. It will come a day when we will find a way. All right, so that's the regular stereo version, and let's have a listen to the eMo. I don't want to go, but baby, we both know this is not our time. It's time to say goodbye. Again, 'cause this is not the end. So to me, it sounds very different. At first, I did not really like it. It just sounded strange. But after working with it a bit, I find that I actually prefer the eMo, the immersive thing, because it's easier to hear all of the instruments without turning up the volume. So let's have a listen again, and I will flip back and forth between the stereo and the immersive.
I don't wanna go, but baby we both know this is not our time. It's time to say goodbye until we meet again, 'cause this is not the end. It will come a day when we will find our way. Violence playing and the angels crying, when the stars align, I'll be there.
So it's quite a big difference. With the stereo, it's kind of close in your head, and with the eMo, it's kind of more spacious. And what I kind of miss is that, for instance, the lead vocal, perhaps I would like that to be more close as in the stereo mix, but with the rest of the instruments, have them more immersive. So again, comparing to Klang, I kind of miss the distance thing where I could have the lead vocal just come closer. So if I were to start the mix from scratch with this eMo system engaged, I would probably make a few different EQ moves on each channel, but I haven't done that for this session in order to just see what are the differences between the stereo and the immersive. But let's start from scratch and try to move things around.
Thank you.
So let's just take this mix that I just did, and let's just flip back and forth between stereo and this immersive thing. So to me, it sounds like, if I'm just listening to the music, I prefer the stereo version. It's more direct, a bit closer. But switching to the immersive, it's a lot easier to pick out the different instruments in the mix. And when mixing in ears, it's all about being able to hear what the other musicians are playing. And I feel with the immersive mixing, it's a lot simpler if I need to pay attention to the guitar, I can just pan my head to find where the guitar is placed within the immersive mix. So I kind of like it so far. And you can, of course, mix all of this with the iPad. And here you will have all of the channels, so volume, and then switch to the pan tab. Here you have the 360 panning, and just hit the IEM at the bottom, and you can move things around like this, and then just go to the next instrument and move things around. And if you press up here where it says IEM, you will have all of the channels, and this is where it gets a bit messy. Because with a lot of channels, it gets really cluttered. It's possible to have all of the channels up at once, and then just try to move things around, or try to find the things to move around. Or you can turn this off and have just all of the channels one by one. One way of making things easier for an artist to mix on the iPad app would be to mix all of the drums down to a drum group, and then have the artist mix the whole drum group rather than all of the individual channels. In this case, I have bass, guitar, piano, organ, vocals, then a group with all of the drums, a group with all of the horns, and a group with all of the backing vocals. So going to the immersive view, then it's not as cluttered as when you have all of the instruments. So that might be a better way for someone who wants some control but don't really need everything. In the beginning, I said that it's not just panning. There are some other stuff going on. So for all of you audio nerds, let's go down the rabbit hole. Let's have a look under the hood and see what actually is going on. Okay, so here I have some pink noise, and on the eMo 3 aux, I have an RTA. So let's bring this to a floating window, and let's go to the eMo 3 send and bring on some pink noise. That sounds awesome. So right now this is set to stereo, so this sounds like pink noise, and if I pan this around, you will hear that there's no change in sound, it's just a change in level. sounds great. Let's switch to the Immersive. And right away you can see that there are a few things going on. Definitely some EQ changes. There might be some phase changes as well, but let's focus on the EQ changes. So let's turn this on again, and then I will move this around in the immersive space, and you will see how the EQ will change. So yeah, there are some drastic EQ things going on as you move things around. You shouldn't really be afraid of this. You shouldn't compensate for this, because this is what makes it immersive. So I think that the best workflow would be to pull up a channel, have it in the front, in the center, do the EQ moves that are necessary, and then pan things around. I think that workflow would make the most sense. All right, that's it. Please leave a comment with your thoughts about this. Will you stay in stereo or go immersive? Do you think there are some benefits or just gimmicky? I don't know. And of course, let me know if you have any questions. And that's it. Take care.